Good morning, my name is Ryan Littlestone from forexflow.live. Welcome to another week. Quiet start this week, not too much going on in the markets. We did have a little bit of worries overnight through Asia weekend news about increases in virus cases. We heard that the state of Victoria in Australia was looking to impose restrictions again on a small rise in cases. We've also got this German abattoir news that's bumped the R rate up, as they like to call it, in Germany above 1.0 to something like 2.88. Bit of a localised incident that's bumped that rate, but it's another case of virus cases rising. And then we've got the US, which continue to see some of these states showing big increases in cases. So that was a thing that sort of weighed on risk as we came through the sort of the Asia session, but we've come into Monday morning to the UK European session and we're not seeing much of that. We're seeing risk pairs, risk trade sort of attempt a mild recovery, if you like. Now, one of the pairs I'm looking at is euro dollar. Now, towards the end of last week, we've seen it on a bearish slant. We've seen it most of June on a bearish slant. And we're approaching a fairly significant level down around the one sort of 111.60.80 area. It's a bit of a zone that goes back in time to sort of 2019. And it's been one of those levels that tends to stick in your mind, that when you move away from it and come back to it, it tends to have an effect on things. And indeed, on Friday, we saw it tested after we broke through 112 and we got to a low of something like 111.66. And then again, overnight through Asia, we've seen that lows tested again in that low 70s area. It's held again, and now we've seen a move back up through, tepid move back up through 112. So as we can see from the daily chart, I've marked the area there as a zone, the blue zone. It comes in around the 38.2 fib of the move up in sort of late April, beginning of May. We saw the bounce back up from the lows down in the 107s. And so there's a lot in this area, this 111.60.80 area, and it was actually a place I'd be looking at to go long. Now, we've seen a bounce back up, as I say, but it looks tepid above 112, and the market's got this Monday feeling that doesn't quite know what it's going to do with itself, so I'm not really trusting any moves. But if we do get a break below this 111.60 area, then I do expect to see a potentially rapid move down to the low 111s, and that's pretty much the next sticky point that I've got on my view, my charts, about where the price is likely to pull up again and ask some questions of the moves. Now, if we want to see this trend change, and as I say, it's been pretty much throughout the whole of June, then we're going to need to see some of these upside level breaks. So if we come into down the time frames, look at the 15-minute chart that I've got up here, we've really not got much until we get to the sort of 112.50.60 area. And this is still pretty short-term levels, but again, I've marked it as a zone. It's an area that we need to look at. If we get above that area, then we should get a push onto 113, and that might take some of the bearish pressure off, at least that we've seen in this most recent period, the last week or so. But if we get there, and if we get up to those 113s, then we potentially could push on. If we don't, if we hit the sort of 112.50.60 area, we could find that as a place where resistance is sitting firmly, and then we get another move back down towards this 112 and this 111.60.80 area. So what are the trades that I'm looking for on this one? Potentially to have a small short into this 112.50 area. I'm not too certain about trying another long down in the 111.60.80 zone, because if we come back down, it would be a pretty fast return, and I don't like a price coming back to a level. So maybe the trade to look for there is, if we get a break of that 111.60 zone, then we can look at maybe going with a sell stop short, seeing if we push on down to that low 111s. So that's what I'm looking for in the euro. As usual, I wish you luck this week and all the very best for your trading.